when there is a situation we don't like, we can have different mindsets how to handle this. So for example, in the office, we don't feel happy, we don't like to go there, people are not nice, the boss is not nice, I don't like the job. Or in a relationship, you are married and or in a relationship and you don't like the other person. So how to handle this? You can have different mindset about this. And if you are more conscious, probably you are aware of this at what I'm going to say, but if you become more aware of this, then you can handle more consciously your response. So one is that avoidance, you just tolerate the thing, you don't stand up for yourself, you just go there and you suffer. You are passively react emotionally to the situation and you don't think about that you can change, because maybe culturally programmed that, let's say that obey to the boss. Maybe you have this belief that I'm paid the money and I have to do and accept everything. If the boss shouts at me, this is part of the job. Or the other thing, that the first is that you accept the situation and you tolerate, but you hate it. The other is that you accept the situation and you try to change your thinking. So you don't try to change the situation, but you try to change your own thinking. For example, using a different mindset. For example, if the boss is pushing to do this, call the customer again, and you say that's so stupid to call and it's so needy and everything. But okay, you can say that the reason they hired me is to solve problems and somebody have to lead, and my job is to fulfill this requirement to do the manual job and call the customers. So in this case, you can change your mind as, okay, I take away my beliefs about this, that is a stupid idea, and then just follow the boss. And because this is my job, I am paid for this, to solve problems, to help the boss to experiment and do things that they think, and I'm just a part of the big machine. And in this case, probably you will feel better than in the using the other mindset, that this boss doesn't respect me, he just used me, he's a very bad person and I'm nobody. So this is maybe this mindset, that change your thinking, change your attitude, change your evaluation and perspective about this one. This is a different mindset. Another mindset can be that you try to change the environment, the boss, the colleagues. So you negotiate, you come up with new ideas, try to see their perspective and see, okay, this is also that in a negotiation, a mindset that I'm just focusing on my interest, or I really empathize and understand the other person's thinking and situation and emotions, and try to understand them and tailor-made my own method of handling the person. So you can try to talk to your boss that, hey, from this and this perspective, it's not good to do what you suggest, and I have this suggestion. And it sometimes it works, sometimes it not. Because let's say that changing your mindset about tolerating the situation and changing your perspective, it's 100% depends on you. Because this is about your attitude, your evaluation, the situation. But you don't have 100% control over any other person, so you have just maybe a little bit. If you are learning a lot of things to how to influence people, then you can improve the chance, look at this, the probability that you will achieve a result. And in statistically speaking, you can see that what is your result in trying to persuade different people. And then you can improve this. So if you look at this probability statistical mindset, that okay, if I try this method, let's say, okay, polarizing mindset and not polarizing. So if you use polarizing mindset, maybe you can be attractive, a very small group of people, but you will be hated by a lot of other people. So if you go to the boss, you want to persuade the boss, if you have a more polarizing mindset that, hey, I want a good environment, and if I'm not respected here, probably I should go away. So it's a kind of challenging, threatening. So in a, probably in a small percentage of the cases, it will work, and the boss will be more attentive to your problems, but maybe they will fire you. And this okay, let's finish that mindset. That, so for example, if you feel trapped in a relationship, if you are not happy, so you can just tolerate. You can tolerate the situation, but change your attitude. You try to persuade the other person, or you can leave. So this is different mindset in a situation, probably not new for you, but if you see this, let's say four elements. Okay, so back to the polarization as a mindset. So let's say in a dating situation, it can be a strategy also, or in a job interview situation, or maybe in a business when you want to sell something. So this is polarizing mindset, means that you take a very fixed, strong perspective, and you say that either you accept my style, what I want, the method I'm using, or we don't cooperate anymore. Or you try to be soft and pleasing. In this case, if you not polarize, so in this, what happens that people will not hate you, they will tolerate, they will accept you, but maybe they will be not really motivated or interested in you, because you don't have a strong personality, a strong value, a strong goal. Because sometimes people attracted for strong individuality. Like in a dating situation, when the man sometimes selfish, cocky, and then just do whatever he likes, let's say that it will be very attractive, let's say just statistical thinking, maybe 10% of women, and 90% of women will hate this. But then if you try 10 women, then statistically speaking you will get one with a very strong positive feeling towards you, because they liked your strong manly behavior, and then you just ignore the other 90 who will be pissed off. But if you use a less polarizing way, then maybe nobody will hate you. You will be very polite and gentle, but it's possible that maybe nobody or very small percent of women will be really attracted. They accept you as a friend, you will be very nice, they will not avoid you, but maybe they don't feel any attractions because you don't show any leadership skills, any leadership or strong desire. So maybe everybody will be okay with you, but nobody will be attracted enough. For example, in a job interview, that they give the job to you, you are the nice guy, you will not upset women, you will not upset interviewers, but you will not stand out. So which strategy you use, it depends on the situation. Let's say in a job interview, when there are a lot of competitors, you must be able to stand out. So maybe a polarizing strategy is better, because you will stand out, and either they don't like you or like you, but they will remember you. And if they look at your uniqueness in a positive way, then you get the job, and if not, then they will hate you and then get rid of. But if you are just the same as everybody else, then you don't really have any chance. Let's say they have 20 candidates for one job, you have only 5% statistically. So let's say if you know that you are very good, then use the the peaceful, not challenging strategy. Be nice, because they already like you because you have the right qualification, the right work experience. Okay, but if you think that I'm nobody in this for this job, they invited me, maybe they cannot find anybody better, but I don't have any special value, that why they should choose, then use a strategy, a polarizing strategy that have very strong opinion. I give an example that people usually don't say negative things in an interview, in a job interview, about their ex-employers, because they don't want to see that they are very critical, very negative. But you can choose to stand out that you choose something very negative about that person, about your last boss, that person always promised something but never did this. When we had a meeting, he was always late. I told me to tell this to the customer, but he changed his mind. So when you want to polarize, and then it's kind of developing your value, like what is important. You think a very strong person. And let's say if the new employer, the potential employer, likes this, then you have a chance to get the job. If they agree with you that, let's say if this person always keep the time, then probably this person doesn't like other people who are late very often, and will sympathize with you, and will not look at this that is a complaint about the ex-boss. Okay, so look at this example, and then you can choose to polarize. So this mindset, polarizing myself and accommodating myself, that pleasing the other person, not to upset them, not to stand out, that fit to their values. This is a strategy that you can employ.